ancient Lake Lahontan, that large paleo... Wait, just kidding, guys. We're going to take it back, just not back that far. We're going to talk about the modern Lahontan, the one of the reservoir variety. Lake Lahontan. What is there to say? What isn't there to say? First of all, it's awesome. Secondly, it's got this epic dam. And third, there's a whole history to it that we didn't even know about.
So, take a seat and hold on to your hats, because we're going to go on a little history adventure. Lahontan style. So let's rewind it back.
Way back to 1860, when Utah, yeah, you heard that right, Utah had a population of about 6,857. Now, the interesting thing was just 3 years prior in 1857, the population was only 225. That's over a 200% increase in population in 3 short years. That brought a lot of people to the Utah Territory. And with those people came 3 people in particular. 3 brothers, actually. The Williams brothers. And those 3 brothers made a bar /
general store
/ Pony Express. Yes, this place is called Williams Station. And it sits right underneath where Lake Lahontan is today. Now, the importance of Williams Station has to do with the Paiute War. And I could do an entire episode on that alone. But in order to save time, I'll let Bonanza do that for me. What exactly happened? Well, we're not quite sure. We know that if you ask the eldest Williams brother, he was out camping, returned to find his station burned to the ground and his brothers mutilated by mean Indians.
All over the place. Coming right at me. All painted up and naked. I saw some of them break in the station and drag out Burn, Phil. I heard him scream.
He says that they were perfectly upstanding people and that Paiutes came unprovoked and murdered them.
The Paiutes are running wild. Killed 7 or 8 men over in Sun Canyon.
7 or 8 men? Do you know who they were?
Not all of them, but they flat butchered Joe and Ellie Lawrence right outside their cabin.
Now, if you ask the Paiutes, they'll inform you that 2 of their women had actually been kidnapped by the Williams brothers.
Burn, party's been kind of dull the past couple of days.
Now, Mr. Wilson!
Who did this?
They took my wife.
Your wife?
Wilson's. Wilson Station. Kill Wilson men.
They attack Wilson Station, this whole country will go up in flames. Come on, Bruno, we gotta beat them there.
Now, this one incident is what started the Paiute War, a war that would accumulate in the deaths of over 100 people.
I'll do what I can for them. There's been too much killing already.
Which ended in a dramatic standoff and the Native Americans getting back Pyramid Lake, which they so richly deserved.
Winnemucca. Your son lives. We mourn your dead son.
I do not mourn for my son. I mourn for all my sons.
Now, Bonanza's account actually wasn't that far off, and you kind of have to hand it to them for getting the truth out there about what the Williams did to the ladies. Inexplicably, Williams Station actually never makes the map in its own right, so this historic location would completely be lost if it weren't for a man named Smith, who came over from Honey Lake and rebuilt Williams Station and called it Honey Lake Smith. Now you see, Honey Lake Smith does make the map, and it's because of this that we know where the Paiute War started today. Now you might be asking yourself, how do I go visit this really awesome place? Well, sadly, you can't, because it sits underneath the waters of Lake Lahontan. Now, William Station / Honey Lake Smith isn't the only secret that the shores of Lake Lahontan holds. There's also Lahontan City. Wait, what are you talking about, Harmony? Lahontan City? I've never heard of that before. I know, no one has. But it was built to house the workers for the Lahontan Dam.
We are going to take this road that we have no idea where it goes, and we're going to see what happens.
It'll be fun. Maybe.
In 1911, the engineering corps rolled into town and immediately set out to find a spot for the new city of Lahontan. Starting as just a bunkhouse for single men and a cookhouse, there was only 50 people working on the dam. However, within one 11-month time, that 50 workers turned into 200 men and families, all earning an average of only $2 a day, which isn't very much when you consider that the average at the time was $4 a day. So you're thinking, why would anyone earn 50% of the national average? Well, for the town, that is.
Now, the roads of Lahontan City might look a little barren today, but 130 years ago, this was far from the case, as this town boasted every modern amenity that anyone could ever want.
Here in the heart of Lahontan City, we have what used to be the dance hall. Now, this is the same dance hall that the Lahontan band would play at on the weekends to entertain all of the workers for the dam. Plans to build a train station to Lahontan were in development before Lahontan City was even thought of.
They knew that if they were going to build this amazing dam, they were going to need supplies. And the best way to get supplies across the vast sandy desert is via train. So these tracks were built specifically for Lahontan City.
We are standing right here where the train station used to be for Lahontan City. The train came in over here, and we're standing right next to the station. Over here, we had the train station itself, and we still have some debris and some train remnants kind of left over everywhere. What's left today of the train depot isn't much. As you see, the tracks still go by, but the trains have long stopped rolling in. In fact, the last train rolled in 1915, right about the time the town was dismantled. This town came at a pretty hefty price tag.
The first year of construction, the project had missed a bill of $298,000. And by the time it was done in 1915, over $1 million was spent in the making of this dam.
So right about now, you're probably thinking, what happened to Lahontan City? Well, you see, in 1915, the construction for the dam was complete. And there was no longer the need for the company town. So the federal government went ahead and packed up shop, closed everything down, and moved away. And in 1916, the post office had officially closed and the last train had long rolled into Lahontan City. What's left of Lahontan City is what we see today, just a few scattered remnants of the glory that once was.
Stand by me and help me, Jesus, if you please. Jesus, stand by me and help me, Jesus, if you please.
Devil away from me.
Jesus, stand by me and keep the devil away from me.
Brother Gable, drive him back.
He can't be angel, what a time.